Thank you. Exalted One, Jesus. Just a little louder, Jesus. Every voice is one, Jesus. Sing his name again, Jesus. Jesus. Sing it again, Jesus.
like I see this picture of the Lord wiping his name like anointing oil on many in the room. And you know, we're singing Holy and Anointed One, and it's the Anointed One. The Anointed One is the one who anoints. Psalm 23, it says, he anoints my head with oil. He anoints my head with oil. And I see this picture of where there's been an internal just battle in the mind. I see Jesus wiping the fragrance of his name over minds. And I want to encourage you, I want to invite you, if you feel like you've been battling within your mind, to come lay on the carpet as we sing this song. And I really feel like from singing his name, from singing the name of Jesus, I just see him anointing heads with oil. Anointing heads with oil. Jesus, you are the Anointed One, and the Anointed One is the one who anoints. And I thank you for anointing us with your name, with the fragrance of your name, Lord. Only your name brings peace to the mind. Only your name will tenderize a heart. Only your name, Jesus, is soothing to the soul. Lord, your name that has a fragrance. Your name, Lord, that there's a smell of it. And when we smell your name, there's faith where there wasn't faith. We lift up your name, Jesus. Thank you that there's a fragrance to your name that brings change to the physical body. Coming and laying on the carpet, just begin to sing his name, just declare his name. It can be as light as a whisper.
This phrase has just kind of been bubbling in my heart, and it's that his name is like a lullaby that puts to rest our restlessness, that puts to rest our striving. When we remember that Jesus is the shepherd of our soul, the one who leads us by his voice beside still water and green pasture, who makes us lie down, that Jesus is our shepherd, acquainted with our ways, faithfully committed to losing not one. And so we sing your name, Jesus, as a lullaby for our restlessness. And we recall and remember that you are the shepherd of our souls, that you have promised faithfulness to us, that you promised to lead us, to provide for us, to care for us, that the weight is not on our shoulders, but that you've taken off our burdens and you've given us a yoke that is light. You are a faithful shepherd, Jesus, a faithful leader, a steady and constant shepherd, provider. We entrust ourselves to you, those with weary minds and racing thoughts and really big circumstances. We entrust ourselves to you, Shepherd.
Every moment you're with.
Lord, I feel as if my lips were created to whisper your name. That's why you formed us with mouths, so that we could utter your name. We could declare your name, Lord, the way your name, Lord, when it rolls off of my lips, it does something in my heart. It does something, Lord, that no other name does. I can say every other name and nothing changes in my heart, but when I say your name, Jesus, my heart changes at the mention of your name.
Yes.
Jesus, I love your name.
establish your name, O Lord, in this place. Establish your name, O God, in this house. Establish your name, O Lord, in our city. Establish your name, O Lord, in our nation and on the nations of the earth. Lord, your name is like a mighty mountain. Your name, Lord, is like a mighty mountain. It's like a fortress, Lord. Your name is a stronghold. Your name is mighty, O God. Your name, Jesus, is like a mighty mountain. It's like a mighty mountain. Like a fortress, like a strong tower.
identified the children of Israel. And when they would raise the banner, it was this declaration of identity, right? That they would actually take out to war. And the banner of the Lord's name is not just the name, the nature in which we identify with. It's actually the power of God to save and change and deliver. And I kept seeing like one of those news tickers, you know, like the headline tickers just running. Bad news, bad report, the world's falling apart, you know? Bad news, bad news, bad news. Caution, caution. And I just saw the banner of the Lord's name completely wipe that out. And it's so liberating to find refuge in the tower of his name. But our full inheritance as sons is to establish the stronghold of his name on the war front. And I feel like there's an opportunity for us to release and declare the nature and name of God into different areas. And so in a moment, staff, elders, other students, we're gonna pray. We can put up, can we put up that list? No, they may not have it yet. In a moment, we're gonna put up a list of the names of God. And if you, this can be personal, this can be global. If you are troubled by some bad news, troubled by a bad report, troubled by what you see happening in the world, in your neighborhood, there's a name of God, an aspect of his character and nature that is unto salvation for that thing, that one, that place, that environment, that situation. There's salvation in his name. And so I want to invite you, Aaron will be down if you'll, and we're gonna release the name of God into the planet and believe in faith that at the sound of our voice, the mystery of how God works, things are shifting and changing and being released into the earth that is gonna revolutionize stuff. So Aaron will be down here. If you guys wanna start lining up, and let's declare the name of the Lord over different situations.
Yeah, I'm gonna read this verse over us. And I wanna pray out of this verse, but it's Philippians 2. Verse 9, therefore God also has highly exalted Jesus and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven, of those on the earth, and of those under the earth, that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. And I really want to declare the name of Jesus. It's what every knee bows to. Every name that is named bows to the name of Jesus, Lord. And I thank you for highlighting your name to us today, Lord, for establishing the strong tower of your name, Lord. And we just declare your name today, Lord, for at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow. Every knee must bow. Every knee must bow, Jesus. So we thank you for your name, Lord. We lift up your name. We exalt your name. We celebrate your name. We dance around your name. We hold on to your name. We cling to your name. We run into your name. Your name, Jesus, that is a banner. Some trust in chariots and some trust in horses. But we, Lord, trust in your name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. So come on, let's keep singing, keep praying. Allow your heart to be gripped and encounter his name.
Your name is a banner over us.
Wake up. Why are you sleeping, Lord? Get up. Don't reject. Don't reject the victims of human trafficking forever. Why are you hiding your face, forgetting their suffering and oppression? Stand up. Help them, Lord. Save them for the sake of your faithful love. God, I pray that you would send deliverers, that you would send people like Moses and like your son into human trafficking rings, God. I pray that there would be a harvest of pimps in the DFW, God. I pray that you would send people into the laborers, God. Send out laborers, Lord, across the DFW. In Jesus' name, God, I pray that you would raise up deliverers and intercessors of this hour, God. I pray that there would be a great harvest of people that are being suffering and oppression and even trafficking, God. Send out deliverers, send out laborers into the harvest, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jesus, you are our great high priest who rules forever, just like the order of Melchizedek, but there is no end to your rule or reign. So we declare you as a kingly priest, who has no end to his reign, who intercedes for us, who lives to make intercession for us. And I just ask that every heart would come into this revelation. Everyone who claims to understand the gospel would have a revelation of you as high priest. That hearts would begin to walk in the fullness of this. That it would start in our city. That we wouldn't believe half the gospel. That we wouldn't understand half of the gospel, part of it. But we would understand the fullness of the covenant and the oath that God made to God.
This applies to you, I want to invite you to receive it personally and want to declare it over our city, that you are Jehovah Jireh, that you are the provider. And I speak your name, Jesus, as provider over those embedded in generational poverty. Lord, for the line of distinction between North and South Dallas, those who generationally have been locked into hardship and poverty mindsets and lack, Lord, I declare that you are not only the provider of what is needing and what is lacking, but you are the provider of a greater inheritance, a new bloodline, that you are a provider of the breaking and severing of generational curses and poverty. And we release the abundance into the city, Lord. We declare that you are the restorer of the breach. And where there's been a breach between white and black and socioeconomic and North and South, Lord, we declare your name as the bridge that would reach through. And we bless South Dallas. We ask you, God, where briar and thorn have sprung up, that the cypress would begin to grow and the myrtle would begin to grow. Lord, would you do only what you can as Jehovah Jireh, South Dallas, a new generational inheritance in the name of Jesus.
You are the dream giver. And because you are the dream giver, you said, moreover, you called for a famine in the land and that you broke all the staff of bread, but that you sent a man before them, Joseph, who was sold as a slave. You said that his feet was hurt with fetters and that his neck was placed in an iron collar. Until the time that his word came to pass, the word of the Lord tried him. You said that the king sent and released him. The ruler of the people set him free. Who is that wise and faithful servant? And you said, whom his Lord has made master over his house. You said that you would give him food to feed your people at the proper time. So I declare that we are Josephs in this room, and that we will feed your people at the proper time. We don't know a food shortage. We don't know gas prices. All we know is the super living God. And because we know the living God, no weapon that is formed against us will prosper. And every tongue that accuses us in judgment stands condemned.
Jesus, you're the beautiful one.
we say, you are the beautiful one. And when Kevin asked earlier what troubles us, the thing that hit my heart was just the agenda of the enemy in terms of sexual identity, perversion, what God has made beautiful, that God created our sexuality. God made us male and female. So Lord, I don't even know how to say this name, but it's Jehovah is the Lord my righteousness. It looks like Tiskenu. I don't know what it is, but anyway, it is the Lord our righteousness. So as a people who love our God, let's declare his name, Jehovah, the Lord our righteousness, over the sexuality of every person that's living today. God, we just come against the agenda of the enemy, and we say, you created us male and female. And we just say, Lord, would you redeem what you've created? God, we pray protection for the nucleus, the family. That's how you designed just life to work. And so, Lord, for those that are struggling, and I just ask you, if you know somebody who's struggling, whether it's porn, whether it's homosexuality, whether it's some other gender identity issue, you pray for them by name right now, okay? As I pray for someone that I know. Lord, I pray for Carlos. God, I ask that you will redeem him. God, I pray that you will set him free from homosexuality and every other thing that he struggles with in terms of sexual perversion. And I declare that you love Carlos, God. You created him, and we just declare your righteousness and your freedom over his sexuality and over every other person who's lifting up someone right now. We say, God, you are righteous. Lord, I just pray for a sexual revolution of purity in our nation. Awaken us to the beauty and the purity of what you created our sexuality to be. So we say, you are the righteous one. Have your way in and through each of us and those we know. God, we love you.
Come on, sing it over culture.
Sing
it over our school districts. You're the righteous one, God.
world, Lord. And every one of us, Father, that is here, every one of them that is not even here, Lord, in presence, Lord, you had a purpose and a plan for every situation, for trafficking, for depressed, for those that doesn't have a father, for those that has been raped, for every situation you have a plan, Lord. And that's why it is so important, Father, for us to know the purpose that you have inside of us, Lord, that you have birthed it since the womb of a mother, Father. So I pray for your plan, Jesus, because you already done it, Lord. Just like you, Jesus, when you come in this earth, you already knew your purpose and you went for your purpose. It's not that you wanted to save everybody in every world, Lord, but because you were just obedient to the voice of the Abba Father, and you said that it was all about the Father business. So I pray, Jesus, those that are called for trafficking will work in the trafficking, Lord. Those that are called for the crying of the mother, the single mother, will go for the single mother. I pray, Jesus, that your purpose that is inside of them, Lord, will start to birth, Lord. We cry out for the purpose, that we know our purpose, Lord, and we pray, Jesus, that we will focus about the purpose, to hear your voice, Abba, and to focus, because you already have a plan. You already have a plan. So we thank you, Lord. And I remember, Father, as a testimony, when I was worried that I could that I had to save everybody in 7-1 when I was in South Beach, and I saw this person selling a book, and the Lord said, go and buy the book. And I went and buy the book, and that book was about the testimony about the Lord. And he said, you see, daughter, I am bringing armies, you're not the only one. So I pray you rise up army, Father, rise up army in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, that will walk on the fullness of your purpose of that person, Lord. Individually, Lord, you have a plan, Abba. So I pray your plan be done, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Shall be your rear guard. Father, in Jesus' name, I speak this neighborhood, Lord, that is considered one of the darkest places in Dallas. And God, I ask that you would break us up on the inside for these places, God. That you would break us up as a church on the inside for the dark places, Lord. That we wouldn't just go and live in the safe neighborhoods, Lord. But that we would go and we would clothe the naked, Lord. That we would feed the hungry, that we'd bring them into our house, Lord. I pray, Jesus, that you would have to speak to us as your bride. Lord, to stand in the gap, to be repairers of the broken city, God. God, do it in our house, do it in our house, Lord. We speak the banner of your name over the darkest city, and the darkest places in our city, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Zion. The mighty kings right now in Dallas and all over the world are united against our Father who lives in Zion. That's right here, right now. And he says, when they saw God manifest in front of their eyes, these mighty kings were stunned. What we're doing right now, mighty kings of wickedness are stunned when they see the God of heaven, the God of Zion, in puny people, puny us. We are against the mighty kings of wickedness in this place where we live because God lives here. And so, Father in heaven, we just pray that they will tremble and they will be gripped with fear. They will be seized with panic. They double up in frightful anguish like a woman in the labor pains of childbirth, like a hurricane blowing and breaking the invading ships. God, through us, blows upon them and breaks them to pieces. We have heard about these wonders, and then we saw them with our own eyes. Yes, yes, we see with our own eyes, for this is the city right now, right here. This is the city of the commander of army, angel armies, the city of our God, safe and secure forever. Amen.
Butcher this, Yahweh Makadesh, our sanctification. You are our sanctification, and we in this room, we say that we trust you to form yourself in us, God. We thank you that we are children, and we abide and we rest in you, that it's you in us and us in you. So we thank you that you are our sanctification, and would you release sanctification, that you will sanctify us, the revelation of Yahweh Makadesh in the church, in your bride, Jesus. We thank you in Jesus' name.
You said that even on your servants, both men and women, you will pour out your spirit in those days. I will show wonders in the heavens and on the earth, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. For on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there will be deliverance, as the Lord has said, among the survivors whom the Lord calls. So here we are, Father. Here we are, calling on the name of the Son, calling on your name, Jehovah Nissi, Yeshua. Here we are calling. Tune your ear to us. Turn your ear to us once again. Hear your children calling out your name. Yeshua, Yeshua, we call for you, Lord. The great and mighty day of the Lord is upon us. Oh, we call to you, Yeshua, with one voice. We call to you, Yeshua.
Come on, can we stand up? Can we lift our hands? Call out on the name of Yeshua. We call